This is the adventure of the old straw hat. One beautiful summer day, old grandmother was working in her garden. She had a lot of beautiful vegetables there. She had two big round pumpkins, some lettuce, and some carrots. And in the field, her two donkeys and the sheep were calmly eating their grass. It was a very warm day, and so grandmother, she took off her old straw hat for a moment and put it down so she could feel the cold wind playing through her hair. But the wind also found something else to play with, and it took up the old straw hat and blew it high and low and here and there. And grandmother, she ran after it, and she jumped up and down and here and there. But no matter how hard she was running and how high she was jumping, she could not catch up with the hat. And so the wind took the hat and blew it up on the top of the mountain where grandmother couldn't reach. But she wasn't really sad. She smiled to herself. Oh, my good old straw hat. It had been a very good hat for very many years. But now I think it's fancying a little adventure. And she smiled to herself. That would be a funny story to tell my grandchildren. And then she continued working in her garden. And the wind picked up the straw hat again and blew it high and low and here and there. And the wind blew it high and low and here and there. High and low, here and there. Until the hat came to a green meadow, and there it fell to the ground. It was the end of the summer now, and it didn't take long before the first leaves were falling from the trees. And they flew down and fell on top of the old straw hat. And then the first acorns, they fell out of the tree on the meadow. And other fruits from the trees. And then a lot of round hazelnuts. They all fell down on the grass of the meadow. And the first mushrooms, they grew on the grass. It was autumn now, and the nights, they were getting longer and darker and more chilly, until the moment came that the first flocks of snow fell from the ground, and they fell on top of the old straw hat. And on top of the grass of the green meadow. And the snow fell and fell, and more snow. Until finally, the whole meadow and the old straw hat, they were completely covered with a thick layer of soft and white snow. It was winter now, and the nights were very cold and very dark. But below the thick blanket of snow, the hat wasn't so chilly. It was actually quite warm. And more time passed until the snow started melting. And it would melt so much that the old straw hat could peek over the meadow again. And then the first flower of the year came. It was a little snowbell. And more snow melted away. And there were more flowers. And then, when almost all the snow had gone, the narcissus, yellow and orange, they grew. And also some grass was growing, and it grew all through the holes in the head. And it was growing and growing. And then the head thought to himself happily, "I look like a little garden now. Look at me. Look how pretty I've become." It was spring now, and the birds, they built their nests and put their eggs. And then it became summer. And when summer came, a little mouse came to the meadow. And it looked around, and then it saw the old straw hat. And it looked on top of it. It also looked underneath it. And it looked behind the hat. And it looked in front of it. And then it bit a little hole in the hat. And it became sort of a window. And the mouse could peek inside the hat. And from inside the hat he could peek outside. And when he was inside the hat he thought to himself, "Wow, what a big ceiling. This could be a beautiful house. I think I could live here very happily." And so it started scattering around, like mouses do. And it took some little straws with him. And it also took some green and soft moss from the forest. And he even found a few very soft feathers from the birds. And with all of this, he made a soft and warm and cozy bed. That was very nice. And it also started gathering some seeds. And finally, he took all the hazelnuts from the meadow. They would be delicious when the cold winter would come. And so the little mouse worked very hard the whole day through. And when it was getting dark and the evening came, the little mouse, he climbed into his bed. And he fell asleep. warm and cozily and peacefully.